Coleoptera. The Coleoptera order of insects is commonly called beetles. The word Coleoptera is from the Greek, where coleos means sheath and pteron means wing, thus sheathed wing. Because most beetles have two pairs of wings, the front pair, the elytra, being hardened and thickened into a sheath-like or shell-like protection for the rear pair and for the rear part of the beetle's body. The Coleoptera include more species than any other order, constituting almost 25% of all known types of animal life forms. About 40% of all the described insect species are beetles. The diversity of beetles is very wide. They are found in all major habitats except marine and the polar regions. They have many classes of ecological effects. Particular species are adapted to practically every kind of diet. Species in the Coleoptera have a hard exoskeleton, particularly on their forewings. These elytra distinguish beetles from the most other insect species except for the Dermaptera. The Hemilytra or the Heteroptera have a slight resemblance but are not the same, and their function is largely different. Like all armed insects, beetles' exoskeletons comprise numerous plates called sclerites, some fused and some separated by thin sutures. This combines armored defenses with maintaining flexibility. The general anatomy of a beetle is superficially uniform, but specific organs and appendages may vary greatly in appearance and function between the many families in the order, and even more so between the suborders, such as the Eriphagia, that currently seem increasingly to be separate orders in their own right. All insects' bodies are divided into three sections: the head, the thorax and the abdomen, and the Coleoptera are no exception. Their internal morphology and physiology also resemble those of other insects. Beetles are endopterygotes. They undergo complete metamorphosis, a biological process by which an animal physically develops after a birth or hatching, undergoing a series of conspicuous and relatively abrupt changes in its body structure. External morphology. Beetles are generally characterized by a particularly hard exoskeleton and hard forewings, which are the elytra. The beetle's exoskeleton is made up of numerous plates called sclerites, separated by thin sutures. This design provides armed defenses while maintaining flexibility. The general anatomy of a beetle is quite uniform, although specific organs and appendages may vary greatly in appearance and function between the many families of the order. Like all insects, beetles' bodies are divided into three sections: the head, the thorax, and the abdomen. The head morphology. The head, having mouthparts projecting forward or sometimes downturned, is usually heavily sclerotized and varies in size. The eyes are compound and may display remarkable adaptability, as in the case of Wurgligig beetles, where they are split to allow to view both above and below the waterline. Other species also have divided eyes. Some longhorn beetles and weevils, while may have eyes that are notched to some degree. A few beetle genera also possesses ocelli, which are small, simple eyes usually situated farther back on the head. Beetles' antennae are primarily organs of smell but may also be used to feel a beetle's environment physically. Antennae vary greatly in form within the Coleoptera but are often similar within any given family. In some cases, males and females of the same species will have different antennal forms. Antennae may be clavate, filiform, geniculate, moniliform, pectinate or serrate. Beetles have mouth parts similar to those of grasshoppers. Of these parts, The most commonly known are probably the mandibles, which appear as large pincers on the front of some beetles. The mandibles are a pair of hard, often tooth-like structures that move horizontally to grasp, crush or cut food or enemies. Two pairs of finger-like appendages, the maxillary and labial palpi, are found around the mouth in most beetles, serving to move food into the mouth. In many species, the mandibles are sexually dimorphic, with the males enlarged enormously compared with those of females of the same species. The thorax. The thorax is segmented into two discernible parts, the pro and the pterathorax. The pterathorax is the fused meso and the metathorax, which are commonly separated in other insect species, although flexibility articulate from the prothorax. When viewed from below, the thorax is that part from which all three pairs of legs and both pairs of wings arise. The abdomen is everything posterior to the thorax. Extremities. The multi-segmented legs end into 2 to 5 small segments called tarsi. Like many other insect orders, beetles bear claws, usually one pair, on the end of the last tarsal segment of each leg. While most beetles use their legs for walking, legs may be variously modified and adapted for other uses. Among aquatic families, Dysticidae, Halipidae, many species of Hydrophidulae and others, the legs, most notably the last pair, are modified for swimming and often bear rows of long hairs to aid this purpose. Other beetles have fossorial legs that are widened and often spined for digging. Species with such adaptations are found among the scarabs, ground beetles and clown beetles. The hind legs of some beetles, such as the flea beetles and flea weevils, are enlarged and designed for jumping. Wings. The elytra are connected to the pterathorax, so named because it is where the wings are connected. The elytra are not used for flight, but tend to cover the hind part of the body and protect the second pair of wings. They must be raised to move the hind flight wings. A beetle's flight wings are crossed with wings and are folded after landing, often along these veins and stored below the elytra. A fold of the membrane at the base of each wing is a characteristic feature. In some beetles, the ability to fly has been lost. These include some ground beetles and some true weevils, desert and cave-dwelling species of other families. Many have the two elytra fused together, forming a solid shield over the abdomen. The abdomen. The abdomen is the section behind the metathorax, made up of a series of rings, each with a hole for breathing and respiration, called a spiracle, composing three different segmented sclerites, the tergum, the pleura and the sternum. The tergum in almost all species is membranous or usually soft and concealed by the wings and elytra when not in flight. The pleura are usually small or hidden in some species, with each pleuron having a single spiracle. Internal morphology. The digestive system. The digestive system of beetles is primarily based on plants upon which they mostly feed, with mostly the anterior midgut performing digestion, although in predatory species, for example, the Carabidae, most digestion occurs in the crop by means of midgut enzymes. In the Eratiridae species, the predatory larvae defecate enzymes on their prey, with the digestion being extraorally. The alimentary canal basically consists of a short, narrow pharynx, a widened expansion, the crop, and the poorly developed gizzard. After is the midgut that varies in dimensions between the species, with a large amount of cecum, with a hindgut with varying lengths. Typically, 4 to 6 Malpighian tubules occur. The nervous system. All the types found in insects varying between different species, from 3 thoracic, the nervous system in beetles, contain 7 or 8 abdominal ganglia which can be distinguished to that in which all the thoracic and abdominal ganglia are fused to form a composite structure. Respiratory system. Like most insects, beetles inhale oxygen and exhale carbon dioxide via a tracheal system. Air enters the body through spiracles and circulates within the hemocoel in a system of trachea and tracheoles, through the walls of which relevant gases can diffuse appropriately. Diving beetles such as the Dysticidae carry a bubble of air with them when they dive. Such a bubble may be contained under the elytra or against the body by specialized hydrophobic hairs. The bubble covers at least some of the spiracles, thereby permitting the oxygen to enter the trachea. Circulatory system. Like other insects, beetles have open circulatory systems based on hemolymph rather than blood. Also, as in other insects, a segmented tube-like heart is attached to the dorsal wall of the hemocoel. It has paired inlets or ostia at intervals down its length and circulates the hemolymph from the main cavity of the hemocoel and out through the anterior cavity in the head. Specialized organs. Different glands specialize for different pheromones produced for finding mates. Pheromones from species of Rutilinia are produced from epithelial cells lining the inner surface of the apical abdominal segments. Amino acid-based pheromones of Melanthinae are produced from eversible glands on the abdominal apex. Other species produce different types of pheromones. Dermocytes produce esters and species of the Elateridae produce fatty acid derived aldehydes and acetates. For means of finding a mate also, fireflies use modified fat body cells with transparent surfaces backed with reflective uric acid crystals to biosynthetically produce light or bioluminescence. A notable number of species have developed special glands to produce chemicals for deterring predators. The ground beetle's defensive gland located at the posterior produce a variety of hydrocarbons, aldehydes, phenols, quinolins, esters, acids released from an opening at the end of the abdomen. African carabid beetles employ the same chemicals as ants, that is formic acid. Bombardier beetles have well-developed, like other carabid beetles, tracheal glands that empty the lateral edges of the intersegmented membranes between the 7th and the 8th abdominal segments. The gland is made of two containing chambers. Tympanal organs are hearing organs, which is a membrane, tympanum, stretched across a frame backed by an air sac and associated sensory neurons, are described in two families. Several species of the genus Cicindela have ears on the dorsal surface of their first abdominal segments beneath the wings. Two tribes in the subfamily Dynastinae have ears just beneath their pronotal shields or neck membranes. The ears of both families are sensitive to ultrasonic frequencies, with strong evidence indicating they function to detect the presence of bats by their ultrasonic echolocation. Though beetles constitute a large order and live in a variety of niches, examples of hearing are surprisingly lacking among species, though likely most simply remain undiscovered. Reproduction and development. Beetles are members of the superorder Endoterricota, and accordingly most of them undergo complete metamorphosis. The typical form of metamorphosis in beetles passes through four main stages: the egg, the larva, the pupa, and the imago or the adult. The larvae are commonly called grubs, and the pupa sometimes is called the chrysalis. In some species, the pupa may be enclosed in a cocoon constructed by the larva towards the end of its final instar. Life cycle. The life cycle of the stag beetle includes three instars. Egg. A single female may lay from several dozens to several thousand eggs during her lifetime. Eggs are usually laid according to the substrate on which the larvae will feed upon hatching. Among others, they can be laid loose in the substrate, for example, floor beetle, laid in clumps on leaves, for example, the Colorado potato beetle, individually attached, for example, the mung bean beetle and the other seed borers, or buried in the medium, for example, carrot weevil. Larva. The larva is usually the principal feeding stage of the beetle life cycle. Larvae tend to feed voraciously once they emerge from their eggs. Some feed externally on plants such as those of certain leaf beetles, while others feed within their food sources. Examples of internal feeders are most Buprisidae and longhorn beetles. The larvae of many beetle families are predatory like the adults. The larval period varies between species but can be as long as several years. Pupa. As with all endopterygotes, beetle larvae pupate, and from these pupa emerged fully formed sexually mature adult beetles or imagos. Adults have extremely variable lifespans from weeks to years depending on the species. In some species, the pupa may go through all four forms during its development, called hypermetamorphosis. Behavior. Locomotion. Aquatic beetles use several techniques for retaining air beneath the water surface. Beetles of the family Dysticidae hold air between the abdomen and the elytra when diving. Hydrophilidae have hairs on their undersurface that retain a layer of air against their bodies. Adult crawling water beetles use both their elytra and their hind coccyx in air retention, while Wurgligig beetle simply carry an air bubble down with them whenever they dive. The elytra allows beetles and weevils to both fly and move through confined spaces, doing so by folding the delicate wings under the elytra while not flying and folding their wings out just before takeoff. Communication. Beetles have a variety of ways to communicate, some of which include a sophisticated chemical language through the use of pheromones. They can emit both an aggregative pheromone and an anti-aggregative pheromone. The aggregative pheromone attracts other beetles to the tree. The anti-aggregative pheromone neutralizes the aggregative pheromone. Ecology. Under ecology, defense and predation. Beetles and their larvae have a variety of strategies to avoid being attacked by predators or parasitoids. These include camouflage, mimicry, toxicity, and active defense. Camouflage involves the use of coloration or shape to blend into the surrounding environment. This sort of protective coloration is common and widespread among beetle families, especially those that feed on wood or vegetation, such as many of the leaf beetles or weevils. In some of these species, the sculpturing or various colored scales or hairs cause the beetle to resemble bird dung or other inedible objects. Many of those that live in sandy environments blend in with the coloration of the substrate. Chemical defense is another important defense found among species of the Coleoptera, usually being advertised by bright colors. Others may utilize behaviors that would be done when releasing noxious chemicals. Chemical defense may serve purposes other than just protecting from vertebrates, such as protection from a wide range of microbes and repellents. Some species release chemicals in the form of a spray, with surprising accuracy, such as ground beetles may spray chemicals from their abdomen to repel predators. Some species take advantage of the plants from which they feed and sequester the chemicals from the plant that would protect it to incorporate into their own defense. Large ground beetles and longhorn beetles may defend themselves using strong mandibles and/or spines or horns to forcibly persuade a predator to seek out easier prey. Many species have long protrusions from their thorax and head, such as the rhinoceros beetle, which can be used to defend themselves from predators. Many species of the weevil that feed out in the open on leaves of plants react to attack by employing a drop-off reflex. Species with varied coloration do not do this, as they cannot camouflage. Parasitism. Over 1,000 species of beetles are known to be either parasitic, predatory, or commensals in the nests of ants. Technically, many species of beetle and their larvae could be considered to be ectoparasites because they feed on plants and some live inside the bark of wood of trees. But such relationships are generally regarded as herbivory rather than parasitism. A few species of beetles are actually ectoparasitic on mammals. One such species, Platypsilis castoris, parasitizes beavers. This beetle lives as a parasite both as a larva and as an adult, feeding on epidermal tissue and possibly on skin secretions and wound exudates. Pollination. Beetle pollinated flowers are usually large, greenish or off-white in color and heavily scented. Scents may be spicy, fruity or similar to decaying organic matter. Most beetle pollinated flowers are flattened or disc-shaped, with pollen easily accessible, although they may include traps to keep the beetle longer. The plant's ovaries are usually well protected from the biting mouthparts of their pollinators. Beetles as beneficial resources. Beetles are not only pests but can also be beneficial, usually by controlling the population of some pests. One of the best and widely known examples are the ladybugs or the ladybirds. Both the larvae and adults are found feeding on aphid colonies. Other ladybugs feed on scale insects and other mealybugs. If normal food sources are scarce, they may feed on small caterpillars, young plant bugs or honeydew and nectar. Ground beetles are common predators of many different insects and other arthropods, including fly eggs, caterpillars, wireworms and others. Dung beetles have been successfully used to reduce the population of persistent flies and parasitic worms that breed in cattle dung. The beetles make the dung unavailable to breeding pests by quickly rolling and burying it in the soil, with the added effect of improving soil fertility and nutrient cycling. Dung beetles play a remarkable role in agriculture. By burying and consuming dung, they improve nutrient recycling and soil structure. They also protect livestock such as cattle by removing dung which is left, could provide habitat for pests such as flies. With this, we come to the end of the chapter Coleoptera. Thank you.